Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Ushma Tyagi, and it's an honor for me to welcome you all on this remarkable day to the 5th National Dental Excellence Award. With the best possible competitive environment, we have a few of the personalities to underline the contribution. So let's begin, as we have the pleasure amongst us to hear to some of the leaders. May I now please invite on stage Dr. Sarabjit Singh.
At this moment, I would like to thank Prime Time for giving me this opportunity. We know there is no dearth of talent in our country. We have the potential to reach the zenith of glory. However, it can be achieved only by consistent hard work, sincerity towards our profession, and determination to reach the goal. I always feel blessed to become a dentist, or an orthodontist to be precise. I was 30 years back when I was getting admission, I got admission in MBBS at various places. My whole family is in medical background, all super specialists, but then I opted for dentistry 30 years back, and I feel really blessed that I become a dentist, and I'm very proud of that achievement. As per my knowledge, as we know, the first dental college was set up way back in 1920, but there was one college. But nowadays, as we know, there are more than 300 colleges in India, and we are churning out more than 30,000 dentists per year nowadays. And it is said by an estimate that maybe by 2020, we'll have around 1 lakh dentists available for services in India. As focused before by a lot of our doctors and colleagues, that we are really lacking behind the rural dental care problems. We know that we have nearly reached the World Health Organization ratio of 1:8,000 for urban population. But in rural areas, it is still 1:60,000, 1 lakh, so we are really lacking in that. So our focus should be also to emphasize more on the urban areas, as said by our doctors before also. We have realized that a lot of budding dentists nowadays, they leave India and trying to settle out abroad. They might be the most settled person here, they are doing very good, but they will go there and start as a chairside assistant or a hygienist, leaving our country. No one should not do that. You will get everything in this nation. You have to realize if you're going to work hard, you're going to get everything. And most important, you have to be truthful to your patients. On the closing note, all I want to tell all of you present here today is that you should never give up. Even if you are convinced it is all over, be focused, you will always achieve your goal. Thanks a lot.
We also have with us Dr. Veeri Gupta from Mumbai, who shall be invited on the podium to share her viewpoint as well.
I'm Dr. Veeri Gupta, and I practice cosmetic dentistry in Mumbai. Today I'm going to speak about this aspect of dentistry which people think normally is just meant for the film industry. So let us talk about the smile first. Smile is a curve that can make everything straight. Smile is the ability to express a range of emotions with the movement of teeth and lips, and can often determine how well a person can function in the society. Smile conveys warmth, confidence, social status, and career success. Best of all, smile helps you feel good about yourself. A cosmetic dentist is an artist who understands exactly what you want in a smile, why you wear it as your most important accessory, and how to protect it through the ages. Attractive smiles are attractive because they follow the basic rules of nature, and therefore a good cosmetic dentist will have to keep laws of nature in mind besides practicing the basic rules of cosmetic dentistry. Cosmetic dentistry is a branch of dentistry that focuses on improving the appearance of teeth and gums through various dental procedures and techniques. Cosmetic dentistry gives you a dental facelift and a boost to your confidence. It changes your appearance, making you look better and feel happier. Modern cosmetic dentistry and advent of new materials and techniques have transformed the way people think about their smiles. When good cosmetic artistry is combined with the modern dental materials and expert training, you can be assured of a durable, radiant, and healthy new smile that speaks volumes about who you really are. Modern cosmetic dentistry with ultra-advanced equipment allows a visit to the cosmetic dentist to be less daunting and a painless experience.
Now I would like to invite on the podium Dr. Onkar Shetty, Dean D.Y. Patil University School of Dentistry, to share about the lack of qualified dentists in rural area and his thoughts to overcome this lack.
Dentistry as such has been growing by leaps and bounds from the time that I was studying. I was also midway in between to cosmetic dentistry, and today there is 3D printing, there is kinesiology, which talks about how a normal small filling that we all go to dentists for could change the entire posture of a person just because that went wrong. So it is very important that as an educationist, we need to imbibe those perfect qualities that a student requires when he goes out into the real world of dentistry. So I think we are a great nation and we can move forward with a great thing. And salutations to all of you all. Congratulations to all of you all on being here. Thank you.
We would like to thank the dignitaries for joining us today. It's a pleasure to have with us Sri Yoganand Shastri and Sri Amar Singh Ji. So I would like to request Mr. H.N. Jha, Director, Prime Time Research Media, Mr. Surendra Mehrolia, Advisor, Prime Time Research Media, and Mr. Ravi Nayak to kindly come forward and welcome Sri Yoganand Shastri, former Health Minister of Delhi, Speaker, Delhi Legislative Assembly, an educationist, a politician, but above all, a very gentle human being. Let's give a big round of applause to Sri Yoganand Shastri Ji. For being with us today, we would also like to welcome to the ceremony Sri Amar Singh Ji, the man who needs no introduction, very renowned politician. It's a pleasure to have you both with us today. I would now like to invite to the podium Sri Yoganand Shastri Ji to say a few words with us.
जहाँ तक इस सम्मेलन का सवाल है, बिजनेस लीडरशिप का जो सवाल है वो एक बहुत व्यापक है और वो आज से नहीं, शताब्दियों से नहीं, सहस्राब्दियों से जाना माना गया है, प्रयोग में लाता रहा गया है। आप बिजनेस लीडरशिप की बात आज यहां कर रहे हैं, बहुत अच्छी बात है। एक जमाना था जब हम दुनिया में बिजनेस में सबसे ऊंचे थे और हमारे देश को सोने की चिड़िया कहा जाता था और वो वास्तविकता थी। आप यदि नेशनल आर्काइव्स में जाएं, जो जनपथ पर है, और पन्ने पलटे वहां पुराने, तो आपको पता चलेगा कि 1820 तक, 1820 बोल रहा हूं, जरा ध्यान से सुनिए, 1820 तक विश्व व्यापार में हिंदुस्तान की जो भागीदारी थी वो 25% हुआ करती थी, 25%। लेकिन अंग्रेज ने वो तहस नहस किया, हमारा सब व्यापार ठप किए, तो आज हमारी विश्व व्यापार में भागीदारी कितनी है? आप में से यदि कोई बताएगा तो अच्छा लगेगा। विश्व व्यापार में हमारी भागीदारी आज के दिन केवल 1.5% है। कहां तो 25% हुआ करती थी हमारी भागीदारी और कहां आज 1.5% है। तो इस पर गंभीरता से हमें विचार करना पड़ेगा और हमें ही नहीं, जो भी सरकार आए केंद्र में उनको भी गंभीरता से इस पर सोचना पड़ेगा। और यदि आप यहां से कोई ऐसा बिंदु दे सके जो कि केंद्र सरकार और हमारे बिजनेस लीडर्स के लिए मंथन का विषय बने तो और अच्छी बात होगी और आप का यह सम्मेलन सफल माना जाएगा। इन शब्दों के साथ मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूं, धन्यवाद करता हूं और अपने शुभकामनाएं देता हूं कि आप जीवन में सफल हों, अधिक से अधिक आप उन्नति करें और हिंदुस्तान को वही पदवी दिलाएं जो किसी पुराने जमाने में होती थी।
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर फॉर शेयरिंग सच इंस्पायरिंग वर्ड्स। इट्स एन ऑनर टू गेट टू हियर योर थॉट्स। खुशियां